Hey guys, Jeremy here with Simple Life, and welcome to an abbreviated version of Tool Time Tuesday. The fact that I just got a little bit of information that I've gathered from the comment section in one of my previous videos, and I just really want to pass that on to you. So that's the only reason of this video, a very short version of Tool Time Tuesday. We're not going to do viewer's knives in this episode, but let's get right to it. So in the previous video, I talked about checkering files and how you can use them to add jimping to your knives. Now, if you don't know what jimping is, basically they're little serrations, grooves, something that adds in traction. Typically, that's kind of what they're for, to give you a better grip on your knife. Now, in this knife example, I've taken my checkering file and I've put these lines in here, and I've got a really nice set of jimping right here for my thumb. You can use these for decorative purposes as well. You can put them all over the place, but they really, really work good. And one of the harder ways to do it is with a hand file and basically cutting those grooves one at a time. It's very, very difficult to get them nice, even, and concentric. So we had visited the idea of using a checkering file. And what that will allow you to do is basically, I believe this one, oh shoot, what was it, a 20 grooves per inch. So basically we can get, and this one has 16 and then 15 as well. So that's one thing to note about the checkering files. They're not identical on both sides. I learned that the hard way. You know, when you're kind of filing your grooves into there, you want to make sure you remember which side you're using, because if you switch it over, you're actually going to end up with an extra, or you're not going to be cutting on one, because one of these sides has 15 teeth going this way, and then one of them actually has 16 teeth. So that's something to note, but also we're going to get to a little tip to help you with that in just a moment. But anyways, we had talked about that. If you missed that video, you can check it out. I'll put a link to that up in the corner. It's an awesome little tool, and one of the comments that I received, somebody had mentioned, actually quite a few people had mentioned, that if you don't have a checkering file, and these things are not cheap, they're fairly expensive and they're hard to come by. Pretty much you're gonna have to, actually I did find out a place in Calgary that has them. So there probably are local places to you if you live in a bigger city, but one of the easiest places is just to jump onto Amazon and pick up one of these. Again, check out the original video if you'd like a little more information on this thing, but one of the responses, one of the comments I got, was that you can use thread restoration files in lieu of a checkering file. And I thought that was really cool. I'd always been curious about that. And if you don't know what thread restoration files are, basically these are them. So if you've got a bolt or, you know, a stud coming out of an engine case or something that's been damaged, you want to clean that up, they sell these. Now, this is a snap-on set. This is from a 48-piece thread restoration kit. So I've got like all different types of thread chasers, and then it also came with a imperial and a metric thread restoration files. You kind of put these little plastic handles onto them. This, by the way, is one of the best values in Snap-on history, I think. Regular price on the Snap-on truck is $99 for this, and this is a set that I use all the time. Very, very good deal in my opinion. But somebody had made the comment, a few people, that you could use these and they would act the same as a checkering file. And I thought, you know what, that's kind of interesting. I'd wondered about that. And so really what you've got here is you've got on the metric one, you've got the different the thread pitches, and same thing with your imperial. So say if you had a 3/8-16, what is it, 3/8-16? I think so. Anyways, a 3/8-16 bolt that was all messed up. You could just go here, so you've got your imperial 16 threads per inch, and you can just start running it over there, and it'll kind of keep everything lined up. And it'll do a really good job. These things work really, really well for restoring bolts, but I thought, how well do they actually work for putting jimping onto knives? And the truth of the matter is they don't work very well at all. Maybe it's my set, I'm not sure. I mean, this is a Snap-on stamp set. I'm not entirely sure who makes it. It's probably some big company that makes it for a whole bunch of different companies. But this is a good quality set, and when I'm restoring threads with it, I have no issues. But the way that the teeth are designed and the way that they cut is different than a checkering file, than one of these. You know, when you kind of look at them side by side, you can see the difference. These aren't meant for cutting new material. They're not designed to cut material. They're designed to smooth over material. You know, if you have existing threads, these can kind of help reform and kind of, they will do a little bit of cutting for sure, but they're not like this where you can take this to bare steel. These weren't, you would never use these in a, say, a lathe and just be like, it's not a die, right? You know, you got your thread chasing, your die when you're actually putting a brand new thread onto a diameter. That's not what these are, and the teeth are different. They do not work that well for checkering. That's just a fact of the matter. You can do it. I fiddled with it a bit, but if you want to say that, you know, this is a great alternative, no, it's not. Maybe if you had something that you wanted to put a little bit of thumb jimping onto, you could limp by with this, but in my opinion, that's pretty much all you're doing. Then there's the other issue that you're really only working with, I'm not sure what that is, but maybe a half an inch. So if you'd like a longer thing, you're gonna have to step this over, and really, really clunky when you're trying to do that. I tried it, does not work very well. You can step these over if you'd like to get a longer portion of the jimping or the lines in there, and it works fairly well. So anyways, that was the first comment, and I was really excited. Mostly I was excited to tell you guys, say, hey, you know what, here's a cheap alternative alternative, you can buy these at most automotive stores. Like, any, you know, you go to your Napa or whatever you buy your auto parts from, chances are a lot of them are going to have something like this. And I thought, this is going to be so sweet. I'm going to bring this information to you guys. But it's not. It doesn't really work that well. So these things are not the same as these things. Don't confuse them. Like I said, you might be able to get by with one of these, but don't think for somehow that if you use this and it doesn't work well, I'm not going to buy a Checkering file because I tried one of these and this didn't work very well. This is 10 times more efficient. It cuts 10 times better, at least, than one of these things. Now, the next tip that I'd gotten was a really interesting one, and it actually can serve two purposes. So when you get a brand new Checkering file, and you know, for the life of me, I can't remember the gentleman that emailed me. I looked for it probably for half an hour and I couldn't find it. So I do apologize. I'd like to give credit to the gentleman that gave me this tip. And again, that's one of the things that I love about Tool Time Tuesday is that I learn so much from you guys in the comments. And this is just one of those things where I want to pass it on to you guys. So with these Checkering files, when they're brand new, they kind of chatter. When you're kind of like, it like a brand new file and it's really sticking on every tooth and stuff. And the gentleman had sent me a really cool email. He obviously knew what he was talking about. And he says, you know what? One of your best Checkering file is the one right before it's completely worn out. From what he says, these things just get better with age. And you know, that's why a lot of people will treasure their older tools rather than the brand new ones. For many tools, that's the case. And so he said, you know what, when they get older, they definitely smooth out. And that's the one, you're gonna love them once you get a little bit of use into them. But he also had a really good tip. He said, one thing you can do to help prevent some of that chatter with a brand new Checkering file is to just load it up with chalk. And I thought, that's brilliant. So I tried it, and sure enough, you basically just went to the dollar store and bought some cheap chalkboard chalk. And you just kind of load this whole thing up. And I tried it out, and sure enough, it actually cuts a lot smoother and it reduces the chatter significantly. I thought that was a really cool tip. Definitely something I'd like to pass on to you guys. And then the other benefit about this is that, you know, I had mentioned that one side has more teeth than the other. So this is 16 tooth and this is actually a 15 tooth. Well, when you're working, you go to, you know, you're checking out your jimping or you're doing something, you leave, you come back, you pick up your file. Oh shoot, which one was I working on? This way you can remember because it's marked. So if you're gonna decide that, you know, it doesn't really matter which side you start with, but if you start with this side, you chalk it up, boom, 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 and then you can go in, have lunch, come back, get right into it and be like, oh yeah, this was obviously the side I was cutting with because that's the side with the chalk on it. So this is a really, really cool tip. I thought this was wonderful. Again, not my idea. I'm just passing it on to you guys. Hopefully it helps you out. So that's it. That's all this Tool Time Tuesday was about, this abbreviated version. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. And I thank you so much for watching. Cheers.